talking about journalistic writing. And I explained with my own personal experience the transition that took place in my life as a student from being an essayist to a journalist. To be a journalist, there has to be a paradigm shift in the way I craft information. Crafting information is an art. The most common format adopted in journalism is inverted pyramid format. The inverted pyramid format has also advantages and disadvantages. While on the one hand, it saves the time of the readers and also the time of the sub-editors. There are several deficiencies, several limitations in the case of the adoption of inverted pyramid format. The first criticism against inverted pyramid format is homogenization of news. So on the one hand, inverted pyramid format with the headline can attract the reader's attention. An inverted pyramid story can be compared to a train. The railway track is the anchor. Every story is written, crafted with an anchor. So the track is the anchor. The headline can be compared with the whistle of the train whistle. The engine of the train can be compared with the lead or the intro of the story. Every bogey, every compartment of a train can be compared with each paragraph of the story. So if you make a comparison of a train with an inverted pyramid story or a news story, everything is interconnected. There is a natural transition from one paragraph to the next paragraph. There is a logical flow. Everything is mutually linked. It can be compared to a bouquet. A bouquet is made with a large number of flowers. But all these flowers are made into a garland or a banquet, so a bouquet with a thread. That thread is the angle. So while this story crafted in inverted format facilitates the reader, there is always a problem of monotony. When all the items in a newspaper are crafted using a fixed stereotype format, reading will naturally become a boring experience. And therefore, when journalists craft news always in a fixed format, in the inverted pyramid format, there is homogenization. Every news item appears same in structure. And therefore, there is absolutely no scope for creativity. Reading becomes a monotonous experience. And therefore, only those who are keenly interested in information gathering, those who are keenly interested in current affairs, will be prompted to read whatever is presented in a newspaper. And therefore, there has to be a new strategy to attract everybody into the newspaper. Secondly, if you make a study about a comparative analysis of the items crafted in a newspaper in the inverted pyramid format, you will always find the problem of repetition in the story, the problem of redundancy in the story. What do I mean by redundancy? What do I mean by repetition? Very often you will find the headline repeated in the intro. And if you go further from the intro to the body, a story can be divided into three parts. You have the headline, followed by the intro or the lead. Then you have the body. The substantial part of the story is under the umbrella of body. And the last segment of the story is the tail. So if you go deep into an analysis of the content that is appearing in the body, you will find that some pieces of information lying in the intro or in the headline are repeated in the body. This is a serious limitation, because we know in newspaper journalism we are battling with space. If we have more space, we can add more pieces of information, add more stories. Another problem with inverted pyramid structure, if you make a comparison, is the problem of complexity. Most of the inverted pyramid stories will carry a very complicated, complex intro or lead, because normally a complex lead is given, particularly in English journalism, because the readers may not go beyond, some of the readers or most of the readers may not go beyond the opening paragraph because of constraints of time. And therefore, the maximum pieces of information should be integrated in the opening paragraph. And therefore, a summary lead is given. So what is the problem of giving a summary lead? We know in journalism, we answer primarily 5 W's and 1 H. The why, the what, the who, the where and when of an event, of a phenomenon, of an issue. And how of all this? In summary intro, we try to answer all these 5 W's and 1 H into a single paragraph, and very often in English journalism, it goes for a sentence with several clauses. And therefore, there is a problem of complexity, and complexity leads to the problem of understanding. The reader may have to read again the lead to understand what is being given in the lead. And therefore, there is a problem of comprehension in the case of inverted pyramid format. There are several other connected points all linked with this homogenization, and the problem of the redundancy, problem of complexity, and the problem of giving no scope for the writer to use his creative writing skill. Everything is stereotyped. It is because of this phenomenon of this monotonous journalism. Some journalists thought of an alternative. How can we make the newspaper stories attractive to the readers? And there came a journalist who had the background of literature, Roy Clark. Roy Clark was a person who was teaching literature in a college setting. Being a voracious reader, that too novels, stories, short stories, dramas, which demand a lot of creativity from the part of the writer, the novelist and short story writer, and also with regard to the poems, from the part of the poets, a creative mindset is required in literature. So he, on the one hand, he understood that value of inverted pyramid format adopted in journalism, and also realized the potential of the adoption of literature, the writing skill in journalism. The literature writing skill always follows the other format, the pyramid format. The pyramid format, as you know, in literature, the curiosity is aroused, interest is sustained, suspense is maintained, and the climax is revealed only at the end of the novel or at the end of the short story. And therefore, it keeps the readers engaged. And a person who reads a short story, if the interest is aroused, will continue reading that short story or that novel till the end. On the one hand, it is very advantageous because you can keep the readers glued to the story. On the other hand, it is going to be difficult for getting the people who are busy, who have constraints of time, because they may not have time to read till the end, to know the climax, the most important piece of information. And therefore, he decided to go for a blend of writing in literature and the traditional or the most accepted format of the inverted pyramid in journalism. So what is the diagram of the new format that was introduced by Roy Peter Clark? The diagram is that of an hourglass. An hourglass is also called a sand clock. You can go through the dictionary to know how exactly an hourglass looks like. An hourglass is a combination of two bulbs, one on top, and the other at the bottom. And these two bulbs are connected through a neck. And this particular device is used to measure time. The shape of the bulb on top is that of an inverted pyramid. And the bulb at the bottom has the shape of a pyramid. So the hourglass structure that combines the positive traits of inverted pyramid journalism and the storytelling style of literature, of novels, of short stories, was very much acceptable to journalists. What does it imply? So we need to have tools for writing. Every person engaged in a profession will always have a wide variety of tools. A carpenter, the most important tool that he is going to use while working is the hammer. The plumber who is going to work in the house, the construction of a building, will depend on his tool, the wrench. A painter will use his tools, the palette and the brush. At the time of Shakespeare, whenever a drama had to be performed, all the actors always used to go around carrying a bag. That bag used to carry the makeup articles, the costumes, the props, and everything that is required for performance. So every journalist, every reporter also needs to have tools. And I am talking about the most important tools, and the first tool as a writer is the inverted pyramid tool. The second tool is the hourglass. The third tool is the focus format journals, focus journals. And the fourth tool is the narrative journals. Now I am talking about the focus, and I am now talking about the hourglass format, which combines the strengths of the inverted pyramid journalism and the strengths of literature, pure literature. The hourglass format, as you can see in a diagram, has three parts. You have a mini inverted pyramid in the opening segment. And you have in the second segment, the major segment, you have the narrative, which is in the pyramid format. And both these segments, the pyramid format and the inverted pyramid, are connected with a pivot, with a turn. That turn is the transitional paragraph. I'll explain to you with an example. If the story is about an accident, we would like to know how did the accident take place, how many were killed, how many were injured, and how did this accident take place. These are the most important pieces of information that all the readers would like to know while reading this story. And these most important pieces of information are given in the first part of the story. So it begins with a normal teller headline, the headline carrying the crux of the story. It is followed by a lead, an intro, the opening segment, which will answer these important questions that the readers would like to get the answer for. after having given these pieces of information, there is going to be a narration of the accident. How did this accident take place? There has to be a description of this particular accident, and it can be narrated like a story, as we normally do in a novel, as we normally do in a short story. You narrate that accident. Just before the narration, a short connecting paragraph or one or two sentences are given. For example, the police version is as follows. Normally, the most accurate information while reporting a crime or an accident is given naturally by the police and also by the eyewitnesses. So there should be a connecting paragraph linking the pieces of information given in the first part of the story with the narrative that is going to be there, and that is called a pivot, that is called a turn. It can be compared with the neck of an hourglass. So if you report, for example, a cricket match, the best method to report a cricket match, the best method to report an accident, the best method to report a crime is not inverted pyramid but hourglass, because everybody would like to read in an emotive, in an appealing style whatever had happened during the match, a cricket match. While the opening segment will carry information about the total number of runs, the wickets, information about the wickets, the man of the match, the best bowler of the match, while having read these pieces of information, the reader would like to have an experience of this cricket match, and that can be given through a narrative structure giving explanation about the starting point of the match and taking the readers to the most crucial moments of the match, the turning points in the match, the dramatic moments of the match, and everything that is going to be narrated will appear like a story. It arouses curiosity, it arouses interest, that interest is going to be sustained, and the reader will be taken till the end of the story, and there will be an experience of that cricket match while reading it. The same principle is also applicable while reporting a crime. After having given the most important piece of information, the way that crime took place, for example, the case of a murder, for example, the case of a communal violence. What was the starting point of a communal violence? It could begin with a silly incident. That silly incident must have been blown up by certain people with vested interest. Could be a trying to communalize a very silly event and to inject hatred towards another community. So when you narrate incidents connected with that particular event, it becomes like a novel, it becomes like a short story. And that is the way an hourglass story is crafted in journalism.